music and photography and artwork and stuff always mix very well. They go hand in hand, you know. So you get involved with photographers right from the start, do your promo stuff, and then come the magazines. And in those early days, like Melody Maker, I remember, and Sounds in London, you know, with the big photos in black and white, and it evolved into the glossies, you know, the Cream magazine and Hit Parader and stuff, where everything was glossy and colorful and stuff. And I think that even influenced what bands were wearing. You know, some stayed in their black and white look, and others changed to more colorful stuff. You know, I mean, Motley Crue was one of the bands that really profited from, I think, from good photography. You know, and yeah, we went through a colorful phase ourselves, and then went back to the more black and white. You know, which I think suits our music better, because our music is heavy but still colorful. So we don't need the colorful costumes. And then come some photographers in mind. And I remember Mark Weiss. He was like one of the top guys, and it was always great to have a good photographer around, because he could rely on good results, because it was important. It's like a good album review or something like that. And and I still know Mark to this day, and I'm looking forward to working with him again.
Actually, Mark.
Oh, there he is.
Yeah, how you doing?
Where did you come from?
I don't know. I just happen to be here. Well, I have a new book, and it's called The Decade That Rocked.
Okay.
You know?
Cool. And is this for me?
No, this is a mock-up, actually, because it's going to be coming out in June, but you can pre-order it on Amazon.
Okay.
But you were in The Decade That Rocked, obviously, and the first time I shot you was in 1983.
Shoot,
at the Capitol Theater.
Yeah.
Very
amazing.
Sexy. Look at that. There's the black and white look. But then after this look, you went to...
we went color.
You went glam. Molly, because everyone was doing it. Motley Crue.
Yeah, they started it, I think.
85.
And hair out there and everything, and glitter. And,
yeah.
But we did that for 2 years, I guess. And, you know, the
Blitz, went back.
Blitz
everyone
album
did.
And the One Vice of the... No, sorry. Change of Address album.
Yeah.
And then for the next album, we went back.
Well, it seemed like when Guns N' Roses came out, because they came out glammy too in 86.
Yeah.
But then a year later, they went street, Motley went street, and then everyone went street.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So...
Cool. Hey, this is... Great, poor, heavy work of art. All those pictures in there, amazing. And the little anecdotes and stories to go along with them. Great stuff, man.
Thanks for being a part of my history.
Great career.
Thank you.
Yeah, you gotta check it out. The Decade That Rocked. I mean, really rocked.